ahora de un auto tan popular que se está convirtiendo en el Mercedes-Benz CLA 2014, que está teniendo realmente un éxito tremendo muy rápido. Vamos a pasar a una entrevista con el gerente de uno de los dealerships de otra marca exclusiva, la Range Rover y Jaguar, aquí en el sur de la Florida, que nos va a hablar de la demanda que tiene la Range Rover Sport.
Well, Danny here at an event showing off the new beautiful vehicles from Jaguar Land Rover. And as we were talking before off the air, I mean, you guys have like a beautiful lineup of new cars and a lot of new customers coming in to see the cars and wanting the cars, which is a huge change from just a few years ago, right?
Well, you know, I guess a few years ago we definitely saw the economy take a hit, the high gas prices, and it was a tough time for a couple of years. And then I would say back in August 2009, we saw a big change with Range Rover. We started to see a lot of new products, and now with the two new models, three new models, I should say, the Range Rover Evoque, the Range Rover Sport, and the Range Rover, we're seeing more customers than we ever have before. It's bringing all new people to the brand.
Yeah, and especially the Range Rover, all of them, the three of them that you just mentioned, I mean, they're like incredibly popular. And actually, there's like a huge waiting list for for the Sport and the Range Rover, right?
Yeah, we have a little. I would say we have a little bit of a wait. The Range Rover Sport is currently, by my estimates, about a 6-month wait, and the Range Rover, it's very tough to say the exact wait time because we don't really know our order calls, but I estimate about 12 months for a new Range Rover.
Yeah, and is this kind of a good problem to have, changing a little bit the way of American people buy cars? Because in Europe, people order the cars and they wait for them. Here in the U.S., they go into the dealership and they want the car immediately, right? So is this a problem that you have now with so high demand? Do you think it's going to change a little bit the reasoning of the buying process?
No, I think people still want to come in and take what they want, and I think the only reason we're able to create this demand and that people are willing to wait is because they really like the product.
Yeah.
And like you said, it's really popular and it's new. But there's a lot of competition out there. When things aren't new anymore, people may not be as willing to wait.
Yeah.
But it's a problem. It's nice to have a product that everybody wants, but at the same time, you see so many opportunities of people constantly coming in that are willing to do business and buy something that day, and it's tough to tell them they have to wait.
Yeah, exactly. I have a friend that is actually one of your clients, I believe, and she was telling me there's a waiting list, and there's like waiting list and waiting list for the A list, the B list, the C list. It's pretty funny almost, right?
You know, we try to take we try to make the orders and fill them as people order them and do it in order. There's always really valued customers of ours that have been loyal to us and buy cars every year or a couple of years, and we try to accommodate for them a little bit, but for the most part we fill the orders as they're placed.
Yeah. And one last question. How big, it's obvious, I mean, we're here like, and people enjoying the cars and all that. How big of a change has been from Land Rover and Jaguar? From they were owned by Ford, and now they're owned by Tata in India, and like they're basically doing their own thing in England as they know how to do it. And they just leave them alone and do the things that they know how to do.
Yeah, I would say the biggest change we see is their commitment to both brands. They're really committed to changing the image of Jaguar and growing the brand to levels of where it once was. And with Range Rover, I think their plan and their commitment is to take it to the next level and to their goal is to double sales volume. And they have the funds to back it and to invest with the company, which we didn't see that with Ford.
Yeah. We're hearing here the F-Type, and I was going to ask you about the F-Type. I mean, the previous cars that they have, the new models since in the past 5 years, have been good. But this car is a game changer almost, right?
It's definitely a game changer, and it's attracting a lot of attention to Jaguar, and it's filtering through to some of the other models. And, it's a direct competition with Porsche. That's really what they're going after. And, the last 3 months, it's outsold the Porsche 911 and Boxster.
Yeah.
Not combined, but individually, the F-Type has outsold them for 3 months in a row. So it's doing what it needs to do nationally.
Exactly. Well, thank you very much for your time. We're going to try to enjoy a little bit of driving here with the cars.
All right.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye.
Pues ahí estaba Dani Valenzuela del dealership Land Rover North and South aquí en Dade. Y la experiencia que tuvimos manejando los autos de Land Rover y de Jaguar. Y cuando regresemos aquí en Auto 060, vamos a hablar de automovilismo, del Auto Show de Miami y también del test drive del Bentley Continental GTC. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.